Hello students, myself Vikas Agarwal and we are here to discuss KVPY SX paper of 2019 part 1 of physics, and we are discussing question number 1 of physics, which is question number 21 of the paper. So this question says that in a muonic atom, a muon of mass which is 200 times the mass of an electron and same charge is bound to a proton. So basically we are discussing an atom in which there is a proton in the nucleus and a muon is revolving around this proton instead of an electron. The charge on this muon is same as the charge of an electron, which is minus E, but its mass is 200 times the mass of an electron. Okay, now what will be the consequence? Let's try to understand here. So if we write the expression of energy of electron in the nth orbit, it is somewhat like this, like minus of 2 pi square k square z square e raised to power 4 m by n square h square. So it is somewhat like this. So the most important point here to note is that this energy is proportional to the mass of electron. Now, keeping everything same, if the electron has been replaced by a particle whose mass is 200 times the mass of an electron, then it means that in the new atom, the energy of nth orbit will become 200 times the corresponding energy of corresponding orbit in the normal hydrogen atom. Okay, so this equation tells us that the difference of any two energy levels will also become 200 times of the corresponding difference in the hydrogen atom. Okay, so this basically means that the energy of all transitions will go up by a factor of 200. Okay, which also means, like, we write energy as hc by lambda. So if energy goes up by a factor of 200, okay, this means that lambda will decrease by a factor of 200. So Balmer series is the series in which visible light is found. So we can expect, if you don't remember, then you can estimate or you can recall that visible light belongs to 400 nanometer to 700 nanometer range. So if photons of this energy range are increased, the energy of these photons are increased by a factor of 200, then the wavelength range decreases by a factor of 200, which means that now we are discussing wavelengths of few nanometer, which is the range of X-rays. Okay, therefore the correct answer to this question would be X-rays, right? So I guess this is a question, this question may seem like a question which is based on memory or which is based on the information that we need to remember, but few of the facts that we know or we should remember, you can use those facts to make logical conclusions and you know, find out the answer, narrow down the answer to X-rays. For example, I use the fact that visible light is present in Balmer series, so using that you can estimate the range of photons. Of course you can calculate that also, but calculation will take a bit of time. Okay, you can derive the range of wavelength of Balmer series, but that will take a bit of time. Okay, rather you can just estimate the energy range and that will give you a good idea of where the wavelength of the Balmer series in a muonic atom would lie. So the correct answer would be X-rays. So guys, I hope you understood the solution, you liked the solution. Thank you for watching this and stay tuned for the next question.